Welcome. In the following video, I'm going to talk about some basic guidelines for usability when designing multimedia or web-based training. All right, so the first thing I want to just mention a few notes about this little guide that I put together. These are just some basic things. Obviously, this needs to be redone and looked at for every kind of different media training project you're doing. You need to look at these and you take them with a grain of salt. You say, what applies to this project? What does not? Also, obviously, I'm assuming by the time I'm at the point where I'm designing like the style template prototype for what this is going to look like, I've done some kind of front end analysis. I know what my content is. I know who my users are. All that kind of good stuff is already known. I'm not just sitting down and developing a prototype on a project that I don't know anything about. So I just want to kind of, you know, mention that for those of you watching this or listening to it. All right. So I'm going to go through and read these and talk a little bit about each one of these and kind of what I mean. So the first thing is make sure it's a simple and natural dialogue. Speak the user's language. You know, if I'm speaking to, you know, experts on a topic, I need to make sure that my language matches that versus if I'm talking to novices or new users, I'm matching their language. You know, make sure you're speaking to the level of the person. Always make sure that you're not presenting too much content at one time. So my next point is to minimize cognitive load. That's how many, you know, how many concepts I'm trying to get a learner to work with at one time. You know, so I'm not gonna on one screen of my presentation or my training or my content, whatever it is, try to have 100 different things on it. I'm gonna have 1, 2, 3, 4, maybe up to about 5 different concepts on the screen that the learner is working through before I start trying to get them to remember it. Next thing I always consider the multimedia principles, which basically, you know, the main multimedia principle is that, you know, images and text that explain for one another are better than just text alone. Some other basic multimedia principles are no extra details, only have details that the users need to see. Highlight important information. That's like having a cue or a bolded word or different color text when something is important that I want the learners to definitely remember. No busy backgrounds like fonts, screens, not things that don't make sense like that. You know, something in the background where there's like a bunch of images that shouldn't be there. And finally, the last of the what I consider a multimedia principle would be Ph.D's law. And Ph.D's law, basically, what Ph.D's law says is that there should be, so if there is like, if I'm clicking an order of buttons, like, and I have to click one and then maybe click the next, they shouldn't be really far apart on the screen. They should be close to one another. So the closer they are to one another, the better, so that my users don't, there's not a lot of space for them to make a lot of error. And the other thing is that the bigger the buttons are, the easier they are to press than something really, really tiny. So think about that when you're on the mobile phone and you're trying to press a link that's really small and you have to zoom in. How much easier is it to press that button when it's huge? Be consistent in everything. You know, don't have a blue theme in one page, a green theme in another page, and a red theme in the next page, unless you have some really justifiable reason for doing that. Be consistent. All right, colors, 2 to 4 colors max. Fonts should be legible. Layout should be very organized. You know, we're using this some kind of grid structure to lay out. Make sure it's organized. And then follow current font, color, and layout trends. You know, if people really, really like, you know, Arial font, then maybe that's a font you should be using. If they really hate it, you know, see what people like. You know, don't use some odd layout that no one's going to know how to use, or else you're going to have to train people on how to deal with your layout before you even teach them how to learn the content you're trying to present. Make sure that there is feedback throughout the instruction when they're doing something. And I'm not talking about like an organizational strategy, like knowledge checks in instruction. I'm talking about feedback in navigation. Like, okay, you're clicking the right, we know you're on the next screen. So like I might have a little note at the top of the screen or bottom or somewhere that says you're on page 2 of 20. Now you're on page 3 of 20, that kind of feedback. So they know where they are, that they're in the right place. Clearly marked exits should be everywhere. So there should be some kind of exit, home, button, some clear mark that they know how to and what to do. There can be shortcuts or breadcrumbs. If you don't know what a breadcrumb is, I have an example on the screen for those who are just listening. Basically, a breadcrumb is like the trail or the way to navigate to see where you are. So if I was on a homepage and I clicked frequently asked questions and then I clicked what are breadcrumbs, I would be on a page called what are breadcrumbs, but at the top of the screen I would see a little like arrow that said frequently asked questions home, like see the navigation, the map, you know, how did I get here? Deal with errors in a positive and helpful manner. We've all seen, you know, the error 404 page on a website. Sometimes it's very nice and it says, oh, sorry, you know, you're at the wrong place. Please click here to get back. And sometimes you just get this white screen that's just like the default message. So have some easy way for users to get back in the right place. Always develop for the technology, the hardware, you know, that your users are going to be using. So consider their resolution. You know, colors, layout, consider what hardware they have. You know, if they have really low-end hardware, you don't need to develop at 4K resolution. So think about that when you're doing stuff. Or if they're going to have slow internet speeds, you don't develop really high output either. You know, always consider the rule of thirds. I have an image on the screen, but what the rule of thirds is you think of a tic-tac-toe board. And the idea of the tic-tac-toe board is to develop along the lines, especially the intersecting corners. You don't try to put pictures or lay out a screen so it's directly in the middle. You try to lay out along the edges in that pattern, that grid, the nine squares. So you think about that as you're laying out creating a video or you're taking a picture or you're laying out a page. Always provide some kind of help and documentation, like a sitemap, if people get lost. A sitemap, for those of you that don't know, is a page that has every single link to a web page. Or if it was a presentation or a multimedia, you know, some kind of computer-based instruction, it would have maybe a menu that had every single, like, title of the unit, that kind of thing. So they could easily navigate and get around. You know, so a user-friendly layout in that, like, buttons are easy to use, easy to find, that's Fitt's law. Obviously, this will vary on, you know, who the audience is and what the objectives are, but it should be user-friendly color, font. I've already mentioned that, you know, but make sure it's the users actually like it and make sure that the sizes are good. As I mentioned already on the phone, big buttons, not small. And so those are just some basic usability, you know, little rules that I like to go through. Those aren't nearly a comprehensive list, but it's a good place to start when you're starting to write that style guide or develop that prototype of, you know, just some basic things that I should start to consider when I'm developing. Thank you.